Now let's talk about the flat pivot bearing, and the case we are going to discuss about is the uniform pressure. So this is how a bearing will look like. This is the stand of the bearing, the body of the bearing, and we have a shaft which is running in this bearing which has an axial load on that. So the load is W, which is the load in bearing, R is the radius of the bearing surface, and P is the pressure intensity which is, you know, acting on the bearing surface. So if the pressure is uniform, then P will be equal to load upon area, which is pi r square. Okay. Now let us say, if you look at it from the top, the shaft would look like this. Okay, and let us say we take a small ring of radius r, small r, and the thickness of this ring is d small r. So the area of this ring is dA, which is 2 pi r into dr. So the load on this would be dW, which is equal to P into dA, which will give you 2 pi into P into r dr. So this is your dW. Now the frictional force on this ring would be mu into the load on this dW. So you will get 2 pi P mu r dr. That's the frictional force. Now the torque on this particular shaft would be integral 0 to capital R fr into small r. Okay, so you will have 0 to capital R 2 pi mu P r into r becomes r square, and then you will have dr. You can bring this 2 pi p outside the integral sign. This will give you t is equal to 2 pi mu into p integral 0 to capital r r square dr. Okay, this will result in 2 pi mu p r cube upon 3. Now look carefully, if you rewrite this as r into r square, so pi into r square into p, this gives you W. So this becomes 2 mu W r upon 3. That is the torque required to overcome friction. Okay, so let us say this is rotating with an angular velocity omega. So the power required to overcome the torque or to overcome the friction is the torque required to overcome the friction into omega. That gives you 2 mu W omega r upon 3. So this is the power which is required to overcome the friction in a flat pivot bearing, which is having a uniform pressure distribution through it. So make a note of this expression and this expression for the numerical portion. In the next video, we'll look at the same flat pivot bearing, but in that case, we'll have uniform wear.